felt somebody tap me on the shoulder. I thought it was my friend Crow, because I see Crow in the morning and say, what's up, Crow?
What's up, Scooby?
I turned around and it was not the Crow. But you see, standing behind me was Barney. Now, when I first saw him, I was like, oh boy. Like, he was so excited to see me. He's like,
well, hi.
Hello. What are you doing here?
Oh, I came over here to play a game of a best friend.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
That's weird.
Why is that so weird?
Because I don't think anybody here likes you.
No, it's you. You're my best friend.
Are you best friend?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't believe I think you're being friends. I said you were. I was like, look, Barney, look. I know it's the absurd thing, because again, you probably are a really nice dinosaur, but you're freaking me out, man. And I'm sorry to say that I don't have time to play games anyway, because I need to go home to Santama Cruz, okay? So I'll check you later.
Wait.
Huh. What?
Well, I need to go to Santa Cruz, too. Can I have a ride?
You don't need to go to Santama Cruz. You're just saying...
No, it's true.
Well, I would love to give you a ride, Barney, but...
I love you. You love me.
Stop it. That's not what I was going to say. What I was going to say was, I would love to give you a ride, Barney, but...
Yeah?
My car...
Uh-huh.
My car is a mess. Yeah, car's a mess. So sorry.
I don't care.
You don't give up, do you?
No.
You're like the Terminator, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Creepy. Okay, why don't we do this? Since I'm a little embarrassed about my car being in a mess, why don't we do this? You close your eyes, count to 10, I clean in my car, and you can get in, okay? Can we make a deal like that one?
Okay, sounds fair.
Coo-me and coo. So he closed them in his eyes, and he started counting like,
1, 2, 3, 4.
I got in my car and I drove away. I gotta believe he fell for it. He's still up here in Wild West by
5? Hello? 6? Hey, are you still there?
No. I was already long gone. Take him away to Santama Cruz. Well, I got on that road that takes you to Santama Cruz. You know that windy road called Highway 719?
Yeah.
Well, I was driving along like a good monkey should have. None of it either. This old lady pulled up alongside me, and she starts honking and horning me, and I was like, because I could understand if I was driving crazy, but I wasn't. I was driving really nice. But still, this old lady's honking and horning me. I'm like, man, what's the matter with you, old lady? You've never seen a four-year-old drive a car before, or what? I guess not, because she kept honking and horning me. But then I realized something. She wasn't honking at me because she was mad at me. No. She was honking at me to warn me. Yeah. Because she started pointing to the back of my car. And I'm like, why would you be pointing to the back of my car? I look in the rearview mirror. Oh, no one. And there he was.
Wait for me.
Isn't he a little too big to run that fast? But let me tell you right now, he might be ginormous. But look at that guy, Brian! He's super duper fast. Well, luckily I have a good car. It's pretty new. And it's got a good gas power, so I step on the gas, we're flying up the mountain. And it's a good thing that Barney doesn't have gas. Now, sometimes he does. And that story stinks if you know. Well, I was flying on the mountain, right? I get up to the top of the mountain, I drive down the other side in the Santama Cruz. When I get down to Santama Cruz, I look at my rearview mirror. And there, on the tippy top of the mountain, I saw this itty bitty purple dot. I was like, yeah, boy, you're too far away to catch me now. Later, lizard. I was wrong. Well, you see, Barney found a fast way down the mountain. He didn't run down the mountain. I mean, he's fast, but he's not that fast. And he didn't hitchhike. Yeah, can you imagine seeing a purple dinosaur inside a railway?
Hey!
I would drive by and I'd be like, haha, no way. Nah, he fell He's not a very racist.
Baba say Baba say Baba say Baba.
They hit a rock. I know. It's not totally cool though. We hit the rocks. Why don't you find me a really good place to hide? And the best place to hide is Santama Cruz County. Santama Cruz Beach Boardwalk. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because there's lots of people there. You can like blend in with the crowd and stuff. Camouflage. Well, I got in line for the roller coaster ride called the Giant Dipper. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I like that one. It's old school, right? So I'm standing in line, and I just so happened to be standing next to this guy. He was somebody's dad, and he's videotaping his kids going across the baskety sky basket thing across the boardwalk, you know? So we're hanging out, talking, having a good time, whatever. And then all of a sudden, we heard this really strange noise. See, at first it sounded like it was far away, and as time went by, it sounded get louder and louder and louder, until it zoomed right past our head, it sounded just like this. And then we heard a loud kaboom. We turned around into this huge cloud of sand and smoke and dust. I was like, whoa, dude, what was that? The guy that was videotaping was like,
yo, man, I caught that on videotape.
You did?
Yeah.
Well, we wanted to see what it was.
Okie dokie.
So he rewinded the videotape, and he started playing it. And when you could kind of see what was going on, he hit the slow motion button, and you could see Barney fly to the air. Well, I put two and two together, and I realized that loud kaboom sound, the lizard has landed. He turned back around, and from the huge cloud of sand and smoke and dust, up pops the purple head of the dinosaur. And he started walking around, checking everybody out, looking for me, right? While I'm standing in line going, oh, please, oh, see me, please, oh, see me, please, oh, see me, oh, please, oh, see me, please, oh, see me, please, oh, see me. And then he stood right next to me. I looked up at him. He looked down at me.
Well, hi.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm looking for my friend Scooby. Have you seen him?
Huh?
Yeah, I'm looking for my friend Scooby. Have you seen him?
Yeah, I saw him.
Great. Where is he?
He's on the Bumper Rise, like pretty much on the other side of the boardwalk. Pretty much as far away from me as you could possibly get. That's where he is.
Great. Right, thanks. See you later.
Okay, bye-bye. Woo-hoo. I don't get it. He was talking to me, but looking for me. You know what I think happened? I think when he spun around the mountain, I think he spun around a little too much. Well, he go bye-bye that way, so I go bye-bye that way. I want to be one. You're that guy. And as I was leaving the boardwalk, I was like, man, what was I thinking? Hiding at the boardwalk, hello? There's lots of kids there. Barney likes kids. I need a better strategy. Well, I was looking for a good place to hide, but I was a little distracted. You know when you're really hungry and your tummy starts growling at you like,
hey man, feed me.
I was like, be quiet. Well, luckily right by the boardwalk there's this really cool restaurant. I've never really been there before, but my friend Otter said it's pretty cool, and Otter, he's cool, man, congrats. So I go inside the restaurant, I sit down, I order some Frenchy toast and some orange mime juice. The waitress comes over, she sits down the orange mime juice. She looks at me and says, okay, sir, it's your turn. My turn for what? Oh, did you know this is a karaoke restaurant? Karaoke, what's that?
I don't know that.
No, sir, not karaoke. Karaoke. You see, how our restaurant works is when you order the food, I bring the order to the cooks, and while they're cooking the food, you get up on stage and you sing a song. We play the music, you sing the words. That sounds cool and all, but I don't like to sing in front of people, so I'll just skip that part. No, sir, you don't understand. In order to get your food, you have to sing. That's how a restaurant works. You have to sing. Okay. But I don't want to sing. If you want your food, you do. Okie dokie. So I get up on stage. Now look, if you've never done karaoke before, it's pretty cool, because they give you this big book, you flip through, pick whatever song you want, and then they play the music, you sing the words, and I like American Idol. But I get up on stage, right? And the people are staring at me like... And I was like, hey, what you looking at? I flip through the book and I find a song that I know a whole lot much. It's by this band small things. It's like, ah, oh, the small thing. And there's a part of the song that's like, na 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 na. Why are you so excited? I was like, oh, I know the song, I know the song. Okay, calm down. You sound like a crazy monkey. Yeah, maybe I do. Where are my bananas? Why are you playing the song, right? When they started playing the song, I get really nervous. And sometimes when I get nervous, my throat gets a little scratchy. I'm like, I literally have a glass of Wawa sitting next to me. I'm like, oh, that will help my scratchy throat, right? So I go to grab a glass of Wawa. But when I go to grab a glass of Wawa, the whole place started shaking like an earthquake. Like, and at first I thought my eyes were playing tricksies on me, so I'm like, I go to grab a glass of water. It does it again! I'm like, oh man, this reminds me of Jurassic Park. Did you ever see that movie?
Yeah.
If you've never seen it, you should check it out. It's really cool. There's this part in the movie where these two kids are stuck in a car and they're all scared and stuff. And they look at a glass of Wawa and it starts shaking because a big dinosaur is walking towards it. The doors in the restaurant fly open and they're hit.
Wait for me!
Excuse me, where do you think you're going, sir? Sorry, lady, I can't sing my song right now because there's a big dinosaur chasing after me. I don't care, sing your song. No, really, lady, look, he's right there! I don't care, sir.
Sing! Look! I don't care, sing your song!
Okay. So I sing my song. Except for one problem. Instead of singing the Wheel Words to the Blink-182 song, I got the Wheel Words and the Barney. Sang my own version of this song. I would go something like this. I'm a purple things. He's a scary since I love you. What should I do? Run away. Go home. Makes a scream. Ah! And I'm running, puking. Oh yeah. Didn't have a motor on it. Didn't have those paddly oar things either. No. So he too had to use his hand, but his hands... His hands are huge! He put those big clunkers in the water, started paddling his little boat at the sea. Now, remember my boat was a crazy, scary, wumpy, bumbly. Now, Barney's boat, no. He put his clunkers in the water, started paddling his boat. His boat I'm like, dude, what do you want?
Look, all I want to do is play one game. Let me play one game and I'll leave you alone.
It's like, you know what? I don't care anymore. Jump up the boat, sing a song, play a game, give me a hug, whatever. Let's just get this over with.
Okay, here I come.
She starts swimming towards me, right? I'm thinking, what are you doing? Then he starts jumping in the air. I'm like, ah! Turned into a pancake. So I figured I better cheer him on, because if I cheer him on, at least he'll know where I am, right? So I'm like, come on, Barney, you can do it, Barney, you can do it, Barney, I got it. Swimming. pirate. But 20? What was I gonna do? Well, I had no other choice. No other choice but to use my secret weapon. My secret weapon is a scary face I know how to make. So I ducked this up, I swished like this one. I said, okay, pirate, if you come any closer, you're gonna see a face so scary that you're gonna cry for your mama. And did he listen to me? No. I was like, okay, that's it, I warned you. I grabbed the net, started pulling him onto the boat. What a heavy monkey he is. But I get him up over the edge of the boat. I get out some scissors, I start cutting him out of the net. And when I start cutting him out of the net, he had this really strange look at his
face.
I'm like, what's the matter with you?
I don't get it.
What don't you get?
Well, you guys try to run away from me and saying you're scaring me and stuff. Why not just let them hurt me?
Because, Barney, I don't want
to... I love you. Stop it.
Don't say that no more. I will go tell your mom. Hey, is your mama Godzilla?
Well, can we play a game now?
I guess so. Let's just get this over.
Great. What game do you want to play?
I don't know. What game do you want to play?
I like peekaboo.
Huh?
Peekaboo.
I like peekaboo.
Really?
Yeah.
Me too. It's like one of my favorite games.
Hey, we have something in common. Friend.
Don't get carried away. I like peekaboo, but I play a different version of peekaboo.
Really?
Uh-huh. I call it peekaboo extreme.
Wow, that sounds cool. How do you play?
Wait right there and I'll show you. I never saw anything that big. Run, that's just we ran so fast that when his tail was dragging on the ground, there were sparks. But those sparks didn't last for long because he flew off the boat. And when he flew off the boat, he landed in the Wawa. And if you thought that first splash was big, what? No, I was just thirsty. You thought I was going to splash you?
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea. Does he know who I am? or did my costume fool him? I don't know. So I just played along. He looked at me and was like,
well, hi.
So I was like,
hey, Shani.
Well, hi, I'm looking for my friend Scooby. Have you seen him?
Scooby? What are you talking about? I've been looking for my teeth all day. Have you seen my teeth?
No, but if I see your teeth, I'll let you know.
Oh, that'd be great, because once I get my teeth back, I wouldn't mind biting you.
You're a funny old guy.
You don't know the half of it.
Well, if I help you find your teeth, will you help me find my friend Scooby?
Oh, sure. Scooby, Shaggy, Fred, Daphne, Velma, whatever you need, I'll help you find him.
Great.
Hey, yeah, no problem. Hey, why do you need to find that boy so badly for anyway? What's the big deal?
Oh, he's the last person I need.
The last person you need for what?
Oh, he's the last person I need to take over the world.
Oh, that...
Take over the world? Uh-oh. Well, I didn't know what he meant at first. But then I soon learned. Learned of a plan. A plan of Barney's to take over the world. Do you know what that plan was? I'll tell you tomorrow for part 3 of this video.